Okay, I also wanted to video for you the thing I use outside when he's reactive, just so, like a game I use. It's just a pattern game with food going on the ground. He's obviously we've been practicing caught, so he's on there. So whatever, I'll drop it on there. That's good. So all I'm doing is I'm looking for him to look at me, yes, and then I toss the food on the ground. Oh, you didn't see it there. I'll toss the food on the ground, and then I look for him to look at me again. Yes, and then I toss the food on the ground. So I taught him that before, and I use it outside. So if there's something going on, like there's a dog or something, I start by tossing the food on the ground. So food on the ground, and then as soon as he redirects to me, he's kind of distracted by the car. I should have moved it, but... there's food on there. As soon as he redirects to me, then yes, then I mark him again and I toss it. And he's pretty good at this. Yes. Yes. So I found that like a sniffing distraction or a sniffing reinforcement, yes, is the most effective thing for him. It's the one thing that will get him under control the fastest if he's kind of hyper. So yes. And that's like if he's reactive or if he's excited to see someone or he's just like, yes, excited to be out. Yes. Doing reinforcing like on the ground where he's sniffing outside, especially when there's like grass and snow. That's a good boy. When there's like grass and snow and stuff and he's like finding the tree, it really centers him, and I assume, you know, from his breed, it makes sense that the sniffing is really effective for him. Yes. So we play this at home, and we play it a more outside. Yes. When we're out and about, and you'll kind of see, I kind of directed Raylene, yes, on the video where he's like barking at me, and we'll do another one today. Yes. To do it. Yeah. And it's really it's the most effective thing for him. Yes. But he has to redirect to get to earn the reward. Yes. So he can engage with the environment. Yes. And then he has to redirect to me to earn the reinforcement. So this particular game, yes, helps him learn to disengage and then engage and then disengage and engage. So he's practicing the behavior that we want him to do under those more stressful circumstances. So and he's like quite proficient at it here, which is good. And then what I've started doing is just practicing it outside on the property and then outside in public. Yes, when there's no dogs, but there's people, you know, so he's like kind of distracted, but he's still able to focus on the game. Yes, he's just, I want him to look at me in the eyes. He's looking at my hand. He's like looking back and forth. Yes, between my hand. But if we were in a reactive situation and he was really struggling, there's another dog or something, and he looked at my hand instead of my eyes, I, you know, in that situation, as long as he's redirecting to me, I'm not going to be super picky about where he's looking. My criteria when we're inside is a bit higher, but when we're outside, I lower it down. Like, as long as you turn to face me, yes, and you're engaged in the food, then you can have it, because I just want him to earn it, basically. Like, I'm making it easy for him to earn it, because in that situation, we don't want to challenge him too much. We want it to be like, you come to me, you get easy reinforcement, turn around, it's better, you'll calm down, it'll feel good, you know, all that stuff. Double.